Here on SharePoint, we are focused on allowing you to transform your intranet into a mobile and intelligence-powered experience. An experience that seamlessly spans on-prem and the cloud through hybrid connections, a one that brings together the productivity of SharePoint team sites, the broadcast reach of publishing sites and portals, and the mission criticality of your most important business applications, all together in one place, so you can find and consume it wherever you are and on whatever device you choose. In the next few minutes, I'll show you this mobile and intelligent intranet with a new mobile app called SharePoint that delivers on the promise of an intranet in your pocket, a home for SharePoint on the web that allows you to quickly find and create sites, refreshed experiences for team sites with a homepage powered by the Office Graph, and I'll explain how every Office 365 group will be getting the full power of SharePoint team sites. Next, I'll give you a tour of a major update to SharePoint document libraries, and I'll show you what modern intranet page creation looks like with a fluid and responsive page authoring experience. And keep watching as I'll show you modern SharePoint lists integrated with PowerApps and Microsoft Flow that can be built to match your team's processes, especially while on the go. Let's start with a tour of the new SharePoint app, coming to iOS, Windows, and Android soon. It delivers on the promise of an intranet in your pocket. Let me go ahead and launch the app. Here we land you on the home of the app, focused on news, both news from your organization and corporation, as well as news from your peers, because we use the Office Graph to detect published content in team sites and blogs and interleave it with the corporate news here. So I can go ahead and click in and see fully published content from anywhere in my intranet. Moving on to the Links tab, this is a list of all the important sites and portals and apps, both on-prem and the cloud. One of the best things about the SharePoint mobile app is that all your existing investments in SharePoint portals appear right in the app from day one. And of course, as you make go-forward investment in new portals or complementing existing ones, you can use the SharePoint framework to deeply integrate your custom UX into this mobile app. Now let's look at the Sites tab. This is where the app gets deeply personal. Before, we were looking at a We space, a common list of intranet portals as well as corporate news. But here, we've used the Office Graph to detect the sites you use most often and automatically appear here. Because after all, who has time to hunt around for the sites they use all the time? Of course, if I have a site I know I'll need access to, I can follow it and it'll appear right here. Let's drill into a team site from within the SharePoint mobile app. Here we go, we look at the Contoso marketing site. It has both news and activity by default. News is a chance for members of the team to spotlight and highlight interesting content, decks, pages, blogs that appear right here. Activity uses the Office Graph to automatically detect what's going on in the site. Clicking on this navigation element, I can see I get access to everything in my team site. All the files, document libraries, pages, and lists. I also get access to the navigation of the site right here, so I can build muscle memory between the web and mobile about how to access everything in my site. Finally, we'll look at the People tab. The People tab also uses the Office Graph, and it gives me a list of all the common people that I work with, and I can search for people that don't appear here. If I click into a person, I can see their basic information, who they work with, and what they work on, which is just a really great mobile-first way of approaching the intranet, because it allows me to get back to the content I need incredibly quickly. Now that we've checked out the mobile app, let's take a look at what we're doing to make accessing all this information across your intranet a great web-based experience that complements the app. Here I am in Office 365. I'm going to go ahead and click on the app launcher, and you'll see we have a tile called SharePoint now. We've renamed the Sites tile to SharePoint because we think we have something worthy being a home for SharePoint on the web. Plus, since we'll all be carrying out an app in our pocket called SharePoint, there'll be great parity between the mobile and the web experience. I'll go ahead and click on it and show you the home for SharePoint. There's a lot you should recognize here. The same list of sites that you saw on the mobile app appear right here under Frequent Sites. Of course, we have a little more screen real estate here, so what we've done is given you a little snippet and preview of what's going on in the site. If I scroll down, you'll also see suggested sites. These are sites maybe that you don't interact with all that much, but we think you maybe should check out. You also see corporate links, just like from the mobile app, right there on the left-hand rail as well. So this is really just a great experience for getting back to sites you follow, as well as sites we know you're interested in using the Office Graph. The other thing I can do here is create a new site. Let me go ahead and get the Create Site button. You can see what comes up is a very simple question that really encapsulates what the intranet is, team sites and publishing sites. Hey, do you want a team site that's a content-centric destination of your team? A website of pages, apps, lists, and document libraries? Or do you want a publishing content, more something to broadcast out a message to a wider group of people? I'll go ahead and click Team Collaboration, and you'll see I'm off to creating a team site. I'll give it a name. And you can see, as we mentioned before, we're going to create an Office 365 group when you create a team site. Because after all, the best way of collaborating Office 365 is not only to get a team site, but the full power of Office 365 group, including conversations and planner and all the other capabilities. A couple other interesting things on this page. You notice I can set the group to be public to everybody in the company or private, so only specific members can see it. As well as look at here, IT has added controls to the creation process. For instance, right here, we're asking how sensitive the data is, where I can select low, medium, or high business impact. Office 365 Center compliance rules can be based upon this classification. Plus, everybody in the site will have an idea of how critical and how sensitive the information in the site is. As soon as I hit create, just like when I create a group, I add a couple people to the site, and then I'm done. And I'm taken immediately to the SharePoint team site, where I have a call to action to make my site great and take the most advantage of SharePoint. You just saw how we made team sites incredibly easy to create, and we've made a massive engineering investment in making them incredibly fast to create too, in just a couple seconds. Now let's take a look at this team site after it's been established for a few months and there's some active collaboration on it. Here's the new home for a SharePoint team site. You can see it's connected to an Office 365 group, so I'm clearly told here it's a public group, as well as the compliance classification I entered a little while ago is available for all end users to see. I can see the group members, and I can go to Outlook to see the group conversations. If I wanted to, I could pin something like the group conversations directly to my quick launch, because I have full control over this quick launch. It's important to point out that every existing Office 365 group will automatically get the full power of this team site right here. Other things I want to point out is that by default, we've added news and activity to team sites. Of course, you can take this homepage and customize it and make it look like whatever you want. But the same news and activity you saw on the mobile app appears here as well, where news is a chance for members to spotlight and pin particular pieces of content or write a post about something that's going on with their team. And activity really tells you automatically, using the Office Graph, what's going on in the team site. Now let's look at improvements to the SharePoint document library. The vast majority of team sites today use DocLibs, and since every group gets a team site, the UX I'll show here is what every Office 365 group will use to manage their files. You know, at their core, document libraries need to be versatile, familiar and simple enough for students who just need a basic place to work on a classroom assignment, all the way up to multi-million item repositories that store the contracts at a law firm. DocLibs are awesome at both ends of the spectrum, and we'll see both of those today, starting with the basic needs of files. Here's the new SharePoint document library. The great thing here is that it's a consistent, clean UX across OneDrive Consumer, OneDrive for Business, and SharePoint Document Library, so all files offerings from Microsoft. You can see here, basic commands like open, share, and get a link are available right there, and I can quickly switch to something like a very visual view of the library. It just gives me a rich, interactive way of interacting with the library. Searching is a snap, with quick type-down preview results, as well as when I see more results, I maintain the great visual-looking look of the library directly in the search results screen. One other thing we've added for basic file collaboration is the ability to link to any document, regardless of whether it's stored in the library or not. This is great because you want a library to be a reference for all the files related to a particular topic or team site, not just those stored in the library. So if I click on New Link, I could do something like even paste a YouTube video in here if this video is related to the team site, or select a document I've recently been working on, like this international product launch. I do that, and quickly I can see a link added to the library. Now the document is unchanged in its source location, but we've pulled in the right context so you can see it great here. Let's move on, and that'll allow me to be a power user to really show you, while we've kept the experience simple when we need it, the document library can grow up to really add structure and metadata and organization. For instance, in this library, I've added content types. It's a way of providing templates for the team, so people don't need to start from a blank PowerPoint or blank Word doc. They can start with a Contoso pitch deck or product announcement right there, click on that, and automatically get started with their work. We've also made great improvements to managing metadata in the document library. You can see here I've added a couple columns to this library, and I can add more super easily by just clicking a great dropdown. Entering metadata has never been easier in SharePoint. I can go ahead and click on a particular document, look at its information panel, and immediately starting interacting with metadata, changing something like an audience to a research and development team. Of course, entering metadata is only useful if you actually use it. So let me show you how you can slice and dice this library, finding exactly the doc you need based upon the metadata that's been entered. Suppose I'm looking for documents that are only ready to be shared with the field, so I can filter by it's field readiness, and I want to present a couple different types of audiences, so I'll go ahead and group this by audience. You can start to see I'm making sense of all the items in the library. If I switch over to the thumbnail view, this is where this view really looks awesome, where I've grouped and filtered, and can immediately drill into just the documents that I'm looking for. Even better, we've added a new feature called pinning. So if this particular document I know is important to almost everybody that visits a library, I can pin it to the top, and it's there no matter what I do to the view down below. Now I want to show you one more thing that I know you're going to love. We've made copying and moving files across Office 365 incredibly simple, because we know in ECM scenarios, the publishing and document lifecycle of files is critical. So right here I can select a document, and I can move and copy it to another document library, or if I'm in my OneDrive, move it to a SharePoint document library. And just like that, we've seen this library grow up to handle traditional enterprise content management. And of course, the library can continue to be customized like it can today. Custom toolbar actions, views, or this can be available as an embeddable web part on any page in SharePoint. Now let's talk about modern pages. Team sites are websites after all, and websites have pages. For instance, to create a trip report or centralize information about a product launch. Let me show you how we made it so fluid to create a page, and it'll look great on any device, and of course from within the new mobile app. Here I am in my team site, and I go ahead, just like today, click Add Page. What you see here is a new modern page authoring canvas, something that's going to keep me on rails so that I create a page that'll automatically look great across any device. I'll go ahead and start creating my page, giving it a title. Take a background image that'll also be reformatted automatically. And as you'd expect when I create a page, I can enter some text. Go ahead and copy paste from the clipboard. And you can see I've given some basic text operations here so I can actually get my message across. Bold, italics, underlined, adding links. And since this page is part of Office 365, of course I'm going to want to reference documents stored in the team site or elsewhere. And I make that super easy by just clicking on Document, selecting a document in the team site, and a rich PowerPoint preview directly on the authoring canvas. I'll add some more text just to make the page look great. Copy pasting from the clipboard. And now I'm going to add a web part. Web parts are really the foundation of what makes page authoring in SharePoint awesome and incredibly powerful. We provide here a great gallery of web parts, everything from Power BI to embedding a list view to a Bing map or maybe a conversation going on in a group. It's just going to be a rich gallery, and you can add your own to this gallery using the SharePoint framework. Now, I'm going to add here a content roll-up web part. This is a web part that keeps the page fresh by using search and the graph to automatically do a search query and put the result on the page. That way, when I add new documents to the site, I don't need to constantly update this page. This is also going to help me show what web parts can do in the new page authoring canvas. Here I can select some settings. For instance, if I want a more list-based view for this web part, I can do that right here. And click Done. I'm completed creating my page, and I can hit Publish. And just like that, I've created an incredibly beautiful page that'll look great on any device. Now let me show you what this page looks like from within the SharePoint app. Here I am back in my Contoso marketing site. I'll go ahead and find this page in the quick launch. And just like that, you can see it looks beautiful on this device. The PowerPoint rich preview has been turned into a card. If I click on it, we'll load in full PowerPoint. And even the web parts have been reformatted to look great on this screen. This is going to really modernize intranet page creation. It allows you to broadcast your message out with confidence, knowing that all your readers will be able to access your information on any device. So we've talked about libraries, and we've talked about pages. Now let's talk about the last major element of the SharePoint team site, the list. You know, over the years, I've heard so many stories about how people have used lists. Everything from tracking engineering bugs, to managing event sessions, or even to cataloging the t-shirt sizes of everyone on the team. It's just a wonderful tool for sharing data and building lightweight processes, and I'm excited to show you a visual refresh to lists that's aligned in look and feel to libraries and pages that I just showed. Here I have a modern SharePoint list. The scenario here is that I'm in an operations site where an operations team uses a document library and a notebook to keep organized, and then they have this big wins list, which tracks all major accounts and ensures an operations lead is assigned to it. Many of the familiar tools you saw in document library are available here too. I can easily add columns to a list right here. I could do something like group by fulfillment status, sort by order size, and really just start slicing and dicing the list up. Familiar tools I might expect from lists today, like Quick Edit, are just a click away. Let me talk about how we might add data to this list. And to do that, I'll tell you about something called Microsoft Flow. Microsoft Flow is a new offering from Azure that lets you connect content and add logic to your business applications, including SharePoint lists. Right here, you can see we have an Add Flow button because we've directly integrated Microsoft Flow into SharePoint. And when I click it, I get a gallery of options for connecting external sources as well as basic logic into the list. In this particular scenario, I'm going to make sure that the work that goes on in Salesforce from the sales team gets into the operations team site and this big wins list. So I'll go ahead and click Salesforce right here. And just like that, I've been taken to Microsoft Flow, and the context of the list is right there. Here's the site and the list that I've just been working with, so I can get started creating my flow super easily. And you can see I can do things like add an action or add a condition. Now let me show you what a completed flow might look like. When an object in Salesforce is created, there's a condition. If the total amount of the deal is greater than $1 million, that's when we need to notify the operations team by creating an item in that SharePoint list and sending a mail. This is awesome. I'm really excited about Microsoft Flows and SharePoint together. It's a great way that SharePoint can be connected to a world of data sources. And of course, we'll bring Microsoft Flow to document libraries as well. Now let's make this scenario even better. If you were the manager of this team, wouldn't you want to easily assign and approve new big wins? And of course, wouldn't you want to do this from any device? Enter Microsoft PowerApps, connected to SharePoint data. PowerApps allows information workers to create mobile apps. Let me pick up my phone and see that I've already created a PowerApp that connects to the big wins list. It's right here on my home screen, or I could have launched it by launching the PowerApp itself. As you can see here, the SharePoint data is available in this app, and I've laid it out for what works for this scenario. I've added the Contoso logo, and I've highlighted stuff in red that needs an assignment. I can quickly click in, take a look, assign an operations lead, and hit approve. And just like that, I've mobilized SharePoint using PowerApps. Of course, we want to make it natural for you to create a PowerApp directly within SharePoint. Let me show you how we've made that easy. If I go back to my SharePoint list, I can see we've added a Create PowerApp button right there. And that allows me to take the context of the list into the PowerApp creation experience. We've also made viewing and consuming PowerApps from within SharePoint easy, where they can be modeled both as a view on a list or library, or even as a web part you can embed on a page. And as you'd expect from a mobile and intelligent intranet, PowerApps will integrate with a SharePoint mobile app as well. Let me pick that back up and go to the Links tab, where you can see the Big Win Approval PowerApps that we've been working with is available directly from within the SharePoint mobile app. With Microsoft Flow, PowerApps, SharePoint document libraries and lists, we are giving you the tools to do rapid application development from directly within the collaboration experience. I hope this tour of what's coming in SharePoint enables you to transform your intranet into a mobile and intelligence-powered experience across team sites, portals, and business apps. Keep giving us your feedback in the product or via user voice. Thanks for watching.